Hey guys, welcome back. Few days back, Xiaomi rolled out the latest version of MIUI, which was MIUI 12, which brought lots of UI changes in their software. So today in this video, we'll be taking a look at MIUI 12 for OnePlus 6 and 6T. First of all, huge thanks to Jay and his team for porting this software for OnePlus devices. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So here you can see this is my OnePlus 6T, which is now running on the latest version of MIUI 12. And if you guys want to install it, download links of this ROM will be given in the description below. And also if you guys want an installation guide, then do let me know in the comment section below. I'll update a video on the same. Going to settings, my device, and here you can see it's MIUI 12.1. Under device name, you'll see MI9, but if you want, you can rename that. Under all specs, you can see Android version is Android 10. And the security patch is 1st July 2020. I won't be covering the features of MIUI 12 because for that you can find lots of videos on YouTube. In this video, we'll take a quick look on few UI changes and we'll show you what all things are working and what all things are not working. So this will be the first look of your MIUI 12 after installing it. Once you install this port, there won't be any kind of camera application. For that, you can use the Google camera application given in the description below and that works fine. If you're not able to install the Google Camera application, you can update me a message on my Telegram group. So now let's talk about this MIUI 12 on OnePlus 6 and 6T series. So as I said, this will be the first look of your device. And now MIUI 12 comes with a new control center. And this is the new control center of MIUI 12, from where you can directly access all your Bluetooth devices, all your Wi-Fi connections without going inside the settings. And if you scroll it more down, you get few more options like dark mode, DND, power saver and ultra power saver mode. Swiping from the right top corner will open control feed and swiping from left top corner will open up notification panel. You can also customize your notification panel just by tapping on this gear icon, where you get lots of options the way you want to see the notifications. Under notification sheds, you can choose between MIUI and Android. Then we'll also find an option of notch and status bar, from where you can also switch control center side. Long pressing on the home screen will give you a few launcher settings, from where you can choose the live wallpapers, going to settings, tapping on more, and from here you can customize your launcher. I've been using this ROM since yesterday. I pretty much found that it can be used as daily driver, but there are few bugs which I'll tell you in a later part. Swiping towards the right hand side will open up App Vault. This is your recents panel. Basic stuff like VoLTE services are working fine. Right now I am using my Jio SIM card and you can see I am able to make a call. Alert slider won't work. And one more thing guys, there will be a new build coming soon, maybe today or tomorrow. So stay tuned for that. All the sensors are working fine like accelerometer, light, proximity, magnetometer, compass and gyroscope. Google Play Store works fine. There are no issues with the Google Play Store. And it's recommended that you don't sign in with your MI account if you have one. Now let's go inside the settings. So here you'll see slight UI changes where you can see under storage section, from where you can get all the details of the space used by applications or other stuff. As I said, under SIM card and network, mobile data was working fine including Jio services. Under Wi-Fi, we have both the bands working fine. Here Bluetooth is also working fine, but media output is little bit low. Then under display, we have always on display which works great. We get lots of options to choose from always on display. If you talk about the lock screen settings, here rise to wake, double tap to wake gestures are not working. Under display brightness section, we have adaptive brightness that seems to be working fine. And the ROM also comes with dark mode. Once enabled, the system will adapt to complete dark theme. We also get features like anti-flickering mode, which is similar to DC dimming mode available on OnePlus devices. Then under sounds, we have basic options, but the UI is completely changed from previous MIUI 11. Talking about password and security, here you cannot use face unlock and fingerprint scanner. Face unlock feature is still available, but due to some reasons, it is not able to access the camera application. Fingerprint option is not available on this build. Then under battery section, we have the same stuff including battery saver and ultra battery saving mode. Inside settings, we get a dedicated section of special features, which includes game turbo, and this feature can be used for gaming, Then we have video toolbox, floating windows, and floating windows can be accessed using your recents panel. Inside your recents panel, you can see towards your left top corner, you have an option of floating windows. Tapping on that will open up supported applications. So let's choose Play Store. And here you can see. Now we have a floating window available on your MIUI 12. To make it full screen, simply drag it from the bottom. And at last, MIUI always have this one-handed mode, which makes easy to use devices with large screen. And the only major bug what you'll find is, you cannot use the device in landscape mode. So if you're watching any video on YouTube, you have to watch that video in portrait mode. If you turn your device or if you rotate the device screen, the device will perform a soft reboot. So this is one major bug what I have noticed. And the last bug which is available on this ROM, you can't use full screen gestures. For right now, you have to use on-screen navigation keys. Hope this thing gets fixed in the upcoming update. Other than this, this ROM can be used as daily driver. I've not personally tested any kind of gamings on this. How many of you guys are interested in MIUI 12 on your OnePlus devices? Let me know in the comment section below. And also let me know whether you want a dedicated video on the installation process. And at last, now let's take a look at the benchmark results. With Geekbench application, single core have scored 500 and multi-core have scored 2319. I wasn't able to perform Antutu benchmark test due to the screen rotating issues on this port. So guys, this was a quick look on MIUI 12 for OnePlus 6 and 60. If you still have any kind of questions, let me know in the comment section below. This is your friend Ashok signing out. See you guys in the next video.